Hello everyone and welcome back to Academically. Today is a very, very special day for all of us as the CAPS results 2024 are out and our students have turned out to be great. They all have successfully completed their CAPS exam. They have successfully, you know, cleared their CAPS exams. So today we have Anjana, who has also been a part of Academically, and she has also cleared her CAPS exam. So Anjana, please tell us, you know, how are you feeling, or rather, you know, what are you feeling? What are your thoughts today? How are you celebrating this huge success for your career?
First of all, thank you Academically for this. And I am grateful for all the teachers and the entire Academically team. It was my dream to go to Australia and work there as a pharmacist, you know. Honestly saying, I'm not a crucial learner, so I just I hadn't done a systematic study this for 5 years, 5 months, sorry. But in the last 2 months, I just work hard and just follow the notes. And even though the classes, since I am working, I couldn't able to attend the live sessions, but I followed the recorded versions and listen to the lectures and makes notes, and I think that makes this dream come true moment. And I'm so glad, and thank you so much for everyone in the Academically team.
We always look forward for this smile, for this you know, relaxation, because we also put in our 100% for you to clear these registration exams. And because Dr. Akram himself is a, you know, he has done his pharmacy, you know, PhD, everything. So he's very connected to pharmacy and CAPS and everything. So he's personally so much involved in this whole process.
Yeah.
So Anjana, moving forward, I would also like to ask you that as you have just cleared your CAPS exam, you know, how was the question pattern? How was the, you know, syllabus? How was your experience in the exam hall? Like the whole experience, can you just share us?
Yeah, sure. While entering, as usual, I was nervous, and by the doing the first part, I feel so free, because most of the questions are from the recourse that you the Academically shared with us, and that will help us me to finish the exam so quickly in the first part. But the second part was a bit difficult, because all the questions were confusing. Kind of right. Twisted that we need to concentrate more on the question so that we could understand the exact thing what they are intended to tell us about. So so I just took more time for the paper too. Yeah. But the calculation part was easy for me, and most I got only 8 to 10 calculations, and out of which 6 to 4 are familiar for me, so I can attend them easily. And while doing the second part, I should say no one should flag the question so simply. Just do the calculations that you know as while we are doing the questions in a row. So that will be helpful, since because I feel that even though one question was there, which I know the answer, but I just flagged it, and I just forget to note down the question mark. But then I checked back, I realized that I just simply flagged it. So in order to avoid that, those who are appeared in November or in the future, that will be helpful to just read the questions carefully, because most of the questions are comparison, or they are performing like least, more, or like that. So we need to concentrate and read the questions and options very well, so that we can choose the right answer.
Right. So also, like, when did you think that, you know, you need a coaching, you know, because there are a lot of people who gets confused that, okay, you know, I can do it, you know, by myself. But when was the time when you realized that you need a, you know, hand to hold on, you know, you need the proper guidance? How did you get in touch with Academically?
Actually, honestly saying, I am, I should say that it was started in 2019, I should say, when I approached one agency who are doing this processing and all. They said that in order to work in there in Australia, you need to prepare and give the caps etc. So yeah. That time I was just 4 or 5 years, 3 to 4 years after completing my post graduation. But
okay.
That time I was scared to attend that exam because you know it's a course, it's expensive, and I was scared to attend that exam.
Yes.
At that time, and
yes.
I just simply spent time and just in the last year I came to know about academically while. I just saw so many ads while I am scrolling through Instagram and Facebook, but I get to touch with that through my one of
yeah.
my friends' friend. So
okay.
She suggested me, and she was a candidate of CAPS, and she cleared in her first attempt
okay.
through academically. So I just do the same.
Okay, that's great. That's great. You know, it's been a good journey for you, and I'm so happy and I'm so glad that you were able to achieve it. So if I talk about the timeline, how much time did it take you to prepare for the exam? Like, how much time were you giving every day? What was your whole study plan like?
Akanksha, I am openly saying that I didn't follow a systematic study plan because I am working and I'm a mom and a homemaker, so I need to adjust my
right
time for
definitely.
Many things in a day.
Yes.
So the last moment, I should say in the May 1st onwards, I just forget about other things and concentrate
yeah.
on this, and just following the notes and classes, listen to the classes and study itself on, and just within 1 month I think around June 15th I finished all the portions.
Oh wow.
And just started revising the things. So I think that hard work that I spent this 2 months.
2 months. Yes.
Yeah.
So it is
that
possible. You see, if you
yeah,
have the,
possible.
If you have the motivation, if you have the,
yes,
you
yes.
know, will to do something, you can do it. And as you mentioned
yes.
that you did it in 2 months, you know, being
yeah,
a
yeah.
homemaker, being a mother,
yeah.
obviously it is a full-time role, you know, being a homemaker,
yeah.
mother is not easy. Obviously I have seen it's
yeah.
not easy. So along with that, you prepared and, you know, you completed everything in 2 months. That's amazing, Anjana. That's amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And the materials are really helpful. And, you know, the it's oriented basically on the CAPS exam point of view.
Yeah.
So it is definitely helpful. And the mocks are also. So once again, thank you academically team for that. Without their help, I can't make it because, you know, the portions are very vast. So in order to
yes.
concise the portion to a capsule format and to study it, definitely can make it in a short time.
Right, right. So now I would just, you know, come to my last question from you, that anything, any final words that you would like to say to the academically team?
I think I would like to put forward a suggestion that
yeah.
in this CAPS exam we got some questions that regarding the portion pharmaceutics. Some portions are a bit I think there was not sufficiently covered in that our section, so I just required the faculty and the team to collect those questions because I couldn't remember those questions exactly. So, but
okay.
However, I will share the portions or the keywords, and I suggest you to just add to that materials.
Definitely, definitely. We, you know, we always welcome all the suggestions and feedback, and we will keep this in mind. And I will definitely convey this to the team, and we will definitely, you know, keep this thing in mind, and we will take an action against this. So please be assured. And once again, I would like to congratulate you, and I would like to thank you for sharing this, you know, all your journey about all this imminent knowledge with us. So thank you so much, and congratulations once again.
Thank you.